Hey there, and welcome to Lunchtime Live at the Center. This week, the Center is recognizing National Infertility Awareness Week to increase awareness around fertility challenges, to help remove any stigma and improve access to family building options. Even though 1 in 8 couples has trouble conceiving or carrying a pregnancy to term, this time can feel really lonely and stressful given all the tests, the appointments, the procedures, and the waiting. There's so much of that. So today we are with Helen Betke-Vargas, who is a licensed acupuncturist, former embryologist, and a master in helping manage the stress around this time. Helen is here to share a couple of quick stress reduction tools and techniques to help ground you and keep you hopeful while you're going through your fertility journey. Hello, Helen, and welcome back.
Thank you, Ami, and thank you for invitation from the center.
Sure. Now, you've worked with a lot of women who are struggling during this time, especially during this time. What are some things you've noticed about them when you're working together?
Well, I have to say, just about for every woman or every couple who walk in to my clinic, one of the first thing they say, and they're very stressed out just from this process. This is aside from work stress, family stress, or whatever else, and some don't have those stressors, but just this process is, challenging to navigate. Mm-hmm. And so any tool that I add to the acupuncture treatment is very supportive, and some of them just like really quick tools, So I want to start by welcoming everyone and to say, just like bring like a mindful awareness or a heartful awareness, really. I'm very big into this, like we're really more heart sensing, and we're trying not to be so much in this realm of thinking. It's very good, but like also staying centered in our body. So notice that we're actually here not watching a TV show. It's really live and many people are present. And just to notice that we are in connection, we are in a connection field here together. And I want to start with inviting you to put your hands on your heart, wherever feels comfortable. And notice that there's a place here that always feels so welcoming to just put your hand on your heart. And bring your intentionality. What is your intention from joining here? What brought you here? And make it an intention for yourself. Take a breath. And my intention from attending this is fill in the blanks. And let's take a breath on that. And one of the intentions that I introduce to my patients with just about every treatment is this affirmation that I learned from years of doing yoga and meditation. And that is, when my patients on the table, I said, let's bring intentionality. My intention from having you here is, and I'll say the words and you can repeat it because we won't hear you, in your loud or in your heart. And that is, may I conceive with ease. May I have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy child, and the family that I've been dreaming of. So that's just the intention we're putting it out there. And by the way, I since 1984, I've been working in the fertility clinic, which was at UConn at the time, as an embryologist. So I've been in this field for a long time. And then becoming an acupuncturist, I found the power of words and the mind and intentionality is important. And I was very big on affirmations. So eventually this year, finally, I developed my own affirmation cards, which they come in a box like this. And on each card, which is a picture of a lovely pregnant woman drawing that's in my
office. Gorgeous.
That affirmation, it says that intention that may I conceive with ease, may I have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy child. And I tell my patients, start, your morning with that. It's okay. Then I want to move on to a really proverb, because I practice Chinese medicine, this proverb that all of us who practice fertility, we say it to our patient, and that is, above all, nourish the soil, so to plant the seed. And that means whether you're, you know, man or woman trying to have a child, to plant that seed to make your eggs healthiest or sperm the healthiest, and then as the embryo implanted in the womb, you have to nourish this, the soil. How do we nourish this body is make sure you're getting enough sleep. That's just most important. Rest, clean, you know, hydrated, clean water, upgrade whatever fuel you're giving to your body. And then the state of the mind, you know, how are your emotions? How are your psyche? And that's, I'll give you a few quick tools to work with.
So you have three of them? Like, yes. And what are the three that you're...
So, well, the first one is simply the moment you notice you're overwhelmed or just walking into the center and it's your first visit and you're getting anxious, or it's your fifth IVF and you're moving into the sixth one, it's your first IUI, or you're trying naturally and you're getting concerned, this is the second month you're trying. The moment you feel like that kind of roaming and anxiety, take a pause. Stop, pause, and breathe. That's all. You're sort of putting a little pause there, a little stop into that whirling that will just take you down into more anxiety for that moment. So stop, pause, breathe, and check in with your body. Am I safe? Oh, I am safe right now. And say it out loud. I'm safe right now. And right now, all is well. I'm healthy. I'm standing. That's it. Just doing that practice is often can break that pattern of just going over and getting anxious. And then just take three breaths. So stop. The moment you notice you're overwhelmed, take a pause and take a breath and check in. You can even put your hand on your heart or just on your shoulder or just feeling in your body and say, am I safe? You're telling your old part of the nervous system, I'm safe. Don't worry. Don't run with this. Nobody's attacking me. There's no tiger running after me, like, because that's the old part of the brain which kept us safe. And then you're saying, all is well right now. I'm just walking to the clinic for my first appointment. And then you'll notice like everything often calms down. So that's first tool. The second tool is then you can, it's called box breathing in the world of yoga and meditation. And that is, if you imagine a box, and we'll count to the count of three, we'll breathe in. So it's like, count of three, breathing in. You hold for the count of three. And you breathe out for the count of three. You hold for a count of three. So as though you're drawing a square, you breathe in to the count of three. You hold for a count of three. You breathe out for a count of three. You hold for a count of three. So let's do that. That's one practice, and you do it about three times. So very easy. How was that, Ami? Were you able to follow me with that?
I did. In the background while I was hiding, I've been following it, so it's been really nice.
Perfect. I just wanted, I'm not going too fast.
No, not at all. And then you are also going to talk a little bit about a tapping.
Yeah. Well, exercise. We move to another. And just another quick breath work,
okay,
which is called heart center meditation. It can be long, but we'll do just a minute of that. And I learned that from this OBGYN, a physician who was doing a lot of workshops on detoxing and hormonal balance. And one of the things she noticed that when we do heart center meditation, those women were able to brought down their cortisol much quicker than any other form of meditation. Of course, there are resources like Heart. I learned that from HeartMath Institute. You can go online. There's many free resources. Our local meditation center, Copper Beach Institute, has many, you know, offerings of meditation. But the Heart Center, I find, is one of the most powerful one. So again, let's put our hands on our heart. Just notice our body and our own heart. And take a breath. You can lower your gaze or just close your eyes. And bring to your heart a presence of someone you deeply, deeply love and admire. And just feel that presence in your heart. It may be your partner, a loved one, a figure, and maybe your four-legged friend. Or it may be an image from not too long ago that you felt a beautiful, blissful, heartfelt moment. So hold this presence in your heart and just breathe through it. Let your heart fill with that deep, unconditional love feeling. And slowly let your body be infused with this energy of deep loving kindness, of this presence in your heart. Just let your whole body fills with that energy, every cell of your body. Nothing to do, just breathe through that. Just hold that. Let's take two more breaths. There. So this was a simple heart center breath work meditation. And I don't know anyone who hasn't done that, who haven't felt like an immediate calming sensation. Again, you can use these at different moments. Great for when you're going to bed or waking up in the morning. And then lastly, the tapping.
Tell us a little bit about tapping.
Yes, tapping often, this has many names. It's become popular in the past decade, 10 years. When I was in acupuncture school, I started hearing about it. And it's really an integration of Chinese medicine and like psychotherapy or like thought therapy, that kind of thing. And actually was accidentally developed by a physician who became an acupuncturist as well. And he was treating a patient of his who was very fearful on fear and anxiety about going into deep water. But she also didn't like the needles. So he's like, what can I do? He said, how about I have her tap on those points that are for anxiety, let's say. And tapping is actually a Qigong practice. Qigong is a form of actually therapeutic practice like yoga, but in Chinese medicine. And often we tap on along the meridians. Meridians are pathways of energy along them. These are acupuncture points when I use acupuncture. And we often tap. It's shaking is another practice, like when you were very old, man. Just put nice music and just shake. You'll feel it's very therapeutic. So these were developed into certain points. And those points are, of course, have certain meanings. But I'll go to a simple version of it and how we can use it for fertility. So the first sentence as you tap will be a sentence that has to do with this thought that comes to your mind about fertility. For example, oh gosh, I've been trying for 6 months. I don't know if I'll ever get pregnant. Or this is my 8th IVF cycle. I don't know if I can do one more. Or, oh my God, I'm very anxious. This is my first appointment with the REs. What are they going to say? And so forth. Okay, you get the idea. So the first is really something that right now is on your mind. So, you know, put that there. And then the second part of the sentence is something that is grounding, a sentence that's grounding. So it's like that. So first, the points, let me actually stand because they're in my hand. So the first one, they call it karate point or karate chop point. And you just tap on these points. So these are the points. The second point is, I'll take my glasses, is right here. And these points are very instinctual. Like Like, oh, when you get tired or overwhelmed, or here, like, oh, I'm little by 3 or 4 of at 4 o'clock in PM when you're working and you're staring on the computer, you're like, oh, yeah. So these or this point here, like, I don't know what I want. So some of these points are very instinctual, and that's why and interesting. Those are acupuncture points. So these are the points: the karate chop, right here, on the side of our eyebrows. Right underneath our eyes and the cheekbone, right underneath your nose, right underneath your lips, and right underneath your chin. And we'll stop here. There's a couple more, but we'll do a short version. So it will be like this. So I'll pretend, like I'll bring a thought process that I know I would be thinking if I was having some struggles conceiving. So I'll say, even though, and you can make your own sentence, even though. It's been 6 months I've been trying and I'm getting hopeless. Now, the second sentence is the grounding point, and you still tap. Take a breath. I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. And that's a powerful thing to say. Then we move to the second point and say the same thing. We're repeating. Even though I'm getting anxious with each doctor visit, I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. And I'm going to take a pause. The tapping can be like this, can be just with your finger points or just with 2 points. Very light or maybe a little deeper. It's all up to you. So we'll continue again. I'll start over. Even though at times I get anxious on this journey, I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. Even though there are times I get hopeless, I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. Even though tomorrow is my transfer and I have butterflies in my heart, I get excited and anxious at the same time. I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. Take a breath. Even though this journey has been long and at times I'm impatient, I know. I have a feeling I may be getting pregnant soon, or I'm hopeful. And I fully, completely accept myself just the way I am. Take a breath under your nose. Even though at times it seems like this never is going to happen, I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. Under the chin. Even though I know I'm okay, everything, it seems normal. It just could be a matter of time, really. And I'm at the best hands. I'm in one of the best centers in the country. I take a breath and I fully and completely accept myself just the way I am. Taking a deep breath in. I know I'm okay. And I know I'm doing everything I can right now. And for that, I accept myself just the way I am. And lastly, it's actually top of the head. And for that, you can say a mantra. Like for example, one of them, my most favorite affirmation that I put in one of the cards that is in this deck of cards. These are really beautiful deck of cards. There are many of them. And a lot of them are just for naturally trying, and there's a segment of them that if you're doing IVF, IUI, and other assisted forms of, and that is knowing that there are many, many women, thousands of women, maybe millions of women before me have had struggles, and you tap, gently with one finger or just like this, something that doesn't bother you. And if that's annoying you, just come back to this point. Or to this point. This is actually my most favorite point. So I will bring it here. So you say, knowing many, many women before me have come through this, have had these same struggles as I have, and have sought help through fertility support. And knowing many, many, many of them have gotten pregnant and right now are enjoying their families. Knowing that helps me, strengthens me, And it supports me just knowing that helps me know that I'll be okay. And take a breath. And of course, the full practice is you do that 3 rounds. And this is a very therapeutic, many therapists use it. I use it in my practice. And often is very, very grounding.
I love it. I was doing it in the background and I haven't done it in a while. So I appreciate the reminder to get back to it. I have a quick question about the grounding statement. If it feels a little strange at first to say that, can you say something simple like, even though I'm feeling stressed and whatever it might be, I'm okay?
Yes, totally. Good. Very good. Good. Because sometimes it's hard for us to move, you know, make that leap, like fully and completely accept myself. I'm already feeling guilty about this, that. Okay. So just saying, I know I'll be okay is a great phrase. Okay.
Okay.
I know, or I know I'm doing my best. You know, I know I'm doing that, because at any given moment right now, you are doing your best. You're doing at this moment what you can. So yes, the grounding can be, and you can all, these are not written in stone. You can make your, or I was giving idea, but let the words come from your inner psyche, inner wisdom, and just trust that that'll be okay. But yes, that's a very good point. If that's very hard to say, and often many of my patients like, I'm not comfortable saying that. Say something that's comfortable for you, your own personal mantra. Yeah.
So you talked about stop, pause, take a breath. Box breathing, heart center meditation, and tapping for stress management, if you will.
That was more for fertility gear, but yes, you use that anything, even anxious or you're feeling fearful. Like, even though I'm very fearful right now, I know I'm okay.
Yeah, these are lovely.
That 3 rounds, and you'll notice, like if you have to gauge it 0 to 10, how you were when you started, and 3 cycles later, which takes really not even 3 minutes, and we have 3 minutes to change, you know, and just doing that, remember, you're dropping your cortisol. When you drop your cortisol, everything else in our body works better. Your digestion, your fertility, all the other systems just are more cohesive.
And these are great. They can be done quickly in small pockets of the day, so you don't have to like schedule a time to do that. But once you do it, the benefits can last even longer than the time it takes to do them.
Yes, there. All these practices are cumulative. Start with one of them, do it. You know, often I know a lot of my patients who just start to work with the center, they're very nervous for that first appointment or just walking to their first IVF. Just at the door before you walk in, look outside before you enter the center, just say, stop, pause, breathe, and I'm okay. Or that box breathing. It takes 1 minute or less, and it will change the way you walk into the clinic.
Lovely. Just lovely. All right. So to our patients and viewers, I hope you will take these tools and use them daily, especially if you're in the midst of a fertility treatment cycle. Helen, thank you so much.
Yeah. And lastly, I do want to say the fertility cards are, you know, they were just published and they're now as a few days ago on my website. So if anybody, and they're in my office as well. So free to purchase. I mean,
what is your website?
Acupuncture Tree of Life.
Lovely. Okay. So, all right. That's all for today. Thank you so much, Helen, and join us again next week. And please also register for our virtual support group. It's tomorrow evening. And Dr. Kim Krohn from the center will be there as our special guest. So you can register on our website at yukonfertility.com. All right. So take care and see you soon.
And best to everyone. Yeah. Thank you.